Holometabolous insects initiate pupal formation and metamorphosis in response to endocrine-dependent events that precede the molt of the last larval instar. As shown in the previous scene, juvenoid titers remain high in accompaniment with ecdysteroids in all larval molts before the fifth instar, thus resulting in immature feeding larvae. However, there are two physiological milestones that occur in the fifth instar that prepare the larva for pupation and metamorphosis into an adult moth. First, attainment of a critical head capsule size of 5 millimeters indicates to the larva that it has attained its last larval instar. Second, the attainment of a critical weight of 5 grams during the fifth larval instar indicates the larva has grown sufficiently to survive pupation and metamorphosis. When the 5-gram critical weight is attained, juvenile hormone synthesis stops and juvenile hormone esterase increases to eliminate all circulating juvenile hormone. In the absence of juvenile hormone, a pulse of prothoracicotropic hormone is released in an 8 to 10 hour period during the next photophase of the daily circadian cycle. The precise timing of the prothoracicotropic hormone pulse indicates it is a gated release to ensure subsequent molt-related events occur during a dark period when the late-stage fifth instar larva is safest from predation. The pulse of prothoracicotropic hormone results in a small release of ecdysteroids that produces commitment of the abdominal epidermis to the pupal molt by replacing messenger RNAs for larval cuticle with RNAs for pupal cuticle. The small titer of ecdysteroid stops feeding and stimulates exposure of the dorsal vessel, purging of the gut contents, and the onset of a wandering behavior during which the larva looks for a suitable protected location for pupa formation. At the end of wandering, a second release of prothoracicotropic hormone stimulates another release of ecdysteroids to initiate the pupal molt. Concurrently, the corporalata produce a small amount of juvenile hormone acid that is converted to active juvenile hormone in abdominal epidermal cells by a tissue-specific juvenile hormone oxidase. This tissue-specific juvenile hormone synthesis allows the abdominal epidermal cells to produce pupal cuticle at the larval pupal molt, but prevents premature metamorphosis by adult-specific tissues such as imaginal disc. During pupation, secretion of ecdysteroids in the absence of juvenoids activates adult metamorphosis by stimulating imaginal disc growth and the formation of adult structures as described in the previous scene on metamorphosis, and initiates the sequence of eclosion events for adult emergence.